these are the kinds of divisive tactics that are quite strategic, right? Because it keeps us divided. I'm on the side of Malcolm. I'm on the side of Martin. Instead of recognizing their humanity, their tireless sacrifice, thank God for each of them.
Another thing that I think has kind of changed from the time that I was a student is that I came up feeling like getting the sense that there were these two leaders in the civil rights movement, and there was Malcolm X and there was Martin Luther King Jr., and they had very different ideas and very different approaches and very different goals. And, you know, in my head, they were at odds constantly, and you had to pick a side. And as I've grown up and as I've learned more and read more, you know, that almost seems preposterous. These men were, you know, certainly had a common goal. They might have had different ideas about how to get there, but I think that they were so much more similar than they were different in you know, what their intent was and what their impact was, and that, you know, you could absolutely subscribe to both of their teachings. And now, you know, I find myself being asked actually constantly, particularly when I'm talking to white folks, who in the civil rights movement, you know, do you admire? Like, whose ideology, you know, are you going to follow? And that's almost offensive to me. But I will tell you that now more than ever, some of the more strident, some of the more powerful messages from your father are resonating with me a lot more than they used to, because I can relate to that never-ending, unyielding feeling of being under attack, of being threatened. And so I also feel this constant state of having my defenses up, of needing to have my defenses up. And I think that your father and his words and his work really help prepare us for that.
Absolutely. You know, I think it's unfortunate when people think that they have to choose one or the other, only really when it comes to the Black, our Black leadership, right? Because we look at Thomas Jefferson, we look at George Washington, we never have to choose one or the other. We simply acknowledge their contribution to America, right? Their contribution as some of the founding forefathers of this modern day America. And when we look at back in history at W.E.B. Du Bois and Booker T. Washington, it's always one or the other. And so these are the kinds of divisive tactics that are quite strategic, right? Because it keeps us divided. I'm on the side of Malcolm. I'm on the side of Martin. Instead of recognizing their humanity, their tireless sacrifice, thank God for each of them. And also that the King family and the Shabazz family are very close. Those are some pictures that I have on my wall. My mother and I, you know, we called her Aunt Coretta, we're very close. And we're grateful that they had the sisterhood in one another, along with Merle Evers Williams. And so, you know, it should, and again, that is the reason why we have to control our own narrative. And, you know, anytime one is prevented from learning about Malcolm X, and Malcolm is depicted as something other than he was, is really such a disservice. My father was only in his 20s when the world learned of him, and he had a profound reaction to this injustice, this big, huge boot that has been on our neck. These knees that we've seen have been on our neck. We forget about what happened during slavery, right? All of the atrocities. We forget about what happened during Jim Crow. We forget about mass incarceration of our poor young children before they're fully developed, locked behind bars and put in solitary confinement. And so we forget about all of these injustices. And I think, especially during this pandemic, when we all witness this horrific death of George Floyd, and then we started uncovering all of these other deaths that continue and persist and have never ended all around the country, that now we look at Malcolm and we realize that is a man of compassion and care and love, who has a profound reaction, because he could have gone into his home He was a very brilliant man. He had a beautiful wife. He had six daughters, and he could have locked himself in, made money, and taken care of his family. And instead, he chose to care by giving Black people shock treatment to understand what had happened to us throughout history. And the only way anything was going to change was when we got up and we did something about it. Men, protect your women. Women, protect their children, family, communities, and so forth. And I think now people are coming to see his humanity.